Wintercreeper was brought to the United States from Asia as an ornamental ground cover in 1907. As seen here, it is still being planted today, often as the popular emerald and gold cultivar, or one of the 50 other known cultivars developed for landscaping. The leaves of Wintercreeper are dark green, finely toothed, and are oppositely arranged along the stem. They are also thick, leathery, and semi-evergreen. The twigs are green and remain green throughout the year. When in vine form, Wintercreeper has aerial roots, as seen here, for climbing trees. The fruit is a white to pinkish red, four-lobed capsule that is visible from September to November. When they ripen in the fall, the capsule split open, revealing four bright red, flesh-coated seeds. These seeds are readily eaten by birds, which aids in its spread from our streets into our forests. In these forests, the shade-tolerant Wintercreeper can be found as a very dense ground cover that can grow up to 3 feet tall. It also grows as a vine that can climb trees up to 70 feet in height, causing decreased growth and even death. Since it begins to grow earlier in the spring than native plants, it will often outcompete and replace them. Where Wintercreeper forms a dense carpet of vines, it depletes the soil of water and nutrients and keeps light from penetrating to the forest floor, thus preventing new tree seedlings and other forest plants from emerging. The failure of invaded forests to regenerate has drastic long-term economic and environmental impacts.
It's having a tremendous impact on the health of the existing stand. I mean, it's competing for moisture. I'd say in a dry year, you'd really see it taking its toll here. As far as regeneration goes, if you look around, there's not much beneath this size of stem to be seen. I mean, it's smothering things out.
If you are interested in joining the fight to help stop Wintercreeper, you can help by doing these simple things. Stop planting Wintercreeper. Instead, plant native species like bearberry, wild ginger, or Virginia creeper. Report any possible sightings to your local Cooperative Weed Management Association or directly using the EdMaps app on your smartphone. Spread the word about invasive species and especially Wintercreeper. Early detection and rapid response are key to stopping the spread of invasive species. If you have any more questions about Wintercreeper, talk to your local Purdue Cooperative Extension educator. Thank you.